Halo, halo, selamat datang bagi yang baru masuk. Selamat pagi. Untuk foto backgroundnya tunggu nanti dulu ya. Agak rame dulu sedikit. Nanti kalau satu persatu orang di-share background videonya, kolom chat nanti penuh. Baik, waktu sudah menunjukkan pukul 9.30 ya. Kita mulai saja ya. Selamat datang kepada Bapak Ibu, para dosen, peserta webinar pada hari ini. Webinar pada hari ini akan berjudul dengan materi Learning Grammar Through Group Project of Animated Video and Class Discussion. Baik, webinar pada kali ini akan dibawakan oleh Ibu Susanti. Ya, waktu dan tempatnya kami persilahkan.
Okay. Yeah. Good morning, everybody. Good morning, senior high school and vocational school students. Also, thanks to moderator Anthony and Johanna. They already given the time for me to convey a workshop. The title: Learning Grammar Through Group Project of Animated Video. Okay. Let me share screen about the material. Wait. Okay. Can you see this, all of you?
Bisa, we can see.
Bentar ya. Okay, can you see this? All the audience?
Yes.
Okay. Yeah, before I explain more about this workshop, let me introduce my name. My name is Ma'am Susanti. I'm the English lecturer at STEMI Pontianak. So happy today I get the opportunity to convey this workshop entitled Learning Grammar Through Group Project of Animated Video and Class Discussion. Okay, before we discuss more about this, let us discuss or see at glance about learning grammar itself. Okay? Yeah. Learning grammar is one of the difficult and boring side of languages. However, it is an important part of teaching and learning process. Ibrahim Bani and Abdul Hamid. I think you have the same idea like this while you are learning English grammar. You get some difficulties, yeah, something that uninteresting, yeah? Okay, let us continue more. The mastery of English grammar, so which most of us lack, that's required. What is it for? Yeah, so it's required for, yeah, to do the formal conversation, to do the presentation, yeah, for a piece of writing, according to the expert Ibrahim Bani and Abdul Hamid, also stated by Urai Afhali and friends. He said that in making comprehensive sentences, also it requires the good mastery of English grammar. Okay, wait. Wait, I have the problem with the share screen. Or maybe I need the moderator to help me to share screen. Yeah, because
Oh,
maybe
okay, ma'am.
unstable connection. Okay, I stop share
Okay.
screen to help me. Okay.
Okay.
Wait, so sorry for this unstable connection, audience.
Bisa dilihat?
Ya. Yeah.
Kalau gini bisa.
Ya, yeah, make it bigger, Anthony.
Udah.
Ya, yeah, oke. Okay.
Oke. Okay.
Oke, okay, we come to the next slide. Oke, okay, let me repeat once again. So the good command of the good mastery of English grammar that's so important for us to do the formal conversation, to make a piece of writing. Yeah, so that's very important for us. Okay, now let us continue. Learners have to. Learners do need to understand English grammar. Why? Since grammar has a major role in English teaching and learning. Muafi, Ali, and friends. In English grammar, so words are classified into 8 parts of speech. Namely, noun, pronoun, adjective, verb, adverb, conjunction, preposition, and interjection. I think that you have learned this, yeah? So all the audience hears. So I think, not I think, but I suppose I know that you have learned this, but maybe you don't know the term. Okay. By recognizing these 8 parts of speech apply both in written and spoken, this is real effective in learning language. Mary Ellen and Caroline, 2011. Next. Okay, let us see. What is the 8 part of speech? Yeah. So I have prepared some sentences here. So you have to pay attention to the blue one. The 8 part of speech. The managers are attending the technological workshop at Graha Hotel. The blue one, the managers, that's the noun. The second, Matt said he has to leave the workshop soon. The blue one, he, that's the pronoun. The second part of speech. The next, we were served very quickly. Very quickly, that's the adverb. The strangers kidnapped a cute girl of a rich family. Kidnapped, that's the verb. Yeah, the part of the 8th part of speech. Okay. Next, a wild crocodile was caught by villagers. Wild, that's the adjective. After the incident, John drove his car to rural. Look at the blue one. After and to, that's the preposition. So as you know, in a sentence, we can use one or more than one preposition. The same like the adjective. Okay, the next example. Siomai and Chai Kue are Kim's favorite, but she also enjoy pizza. And but, that's the conjunction used in this sentence. Oops, I can't believe I forget to bring the book again. So the blue one, oops, yeah, ended by exclamation mark, that's the interjection. Okay, let us continue the next part. The first part of speech, that is noun. Let us see. So in a sentence, noun serves as sentence subject. Noun can be grouped into 4 classes. The first, that is concrete noun, abstract noun, common noun, and the last, proper noun. Concrete noun. So concrete noun, that can be the persons, places, or things you can actually see, you can hear, you can feel, you can taste, you can smell, etc. using your senses. Example, cell phone, laptop, dictionary. Okay, and so many other nouns, as you know. Next, we come to the second class, abstract noun. Abstract noun, as you know, something that cannot be seen. It's so difficult to visualize. Yeah, that's like qualities, the feeling, the concept. So those are difficult to visualize. Example like accuracy, love, happiness, freedom, success, and many others. The third class of the noun, that is common noun. Common noun, yeah, it generalizes person, places, and things. Example, candy, company, magazine, printer, organization, software, television, toy, and so many other common nouns. And the fourth class of the noun, that is proper noun. Proper noun, it's specific person, places, and things. They are always capitalized. Example, the American Airlines. Okay, Business Week, Epson Stylus. McDonald, and some others proper name. Okay, let us continue more. Yeah. So why we have to know about this, the eighth part of speech? Now the second part of speech. The second part of speech, that is pronoun. Let me tell you. I think you have learned this, but you forget about this. Yeah? And this is, we know this. Yeah, we know this, of course, for you while you are learning English. Yeah, for the formal situation. Pronoun. There are seven types of pronoun. The first, personal pronoun. Personal pronoun replace nouns or other pronouns. Example, subjective case, objective case, and possessive case. Subjective case, we have I, we, you, he, she, it, them. Yeah. Objective case, we have me, us, you, etc. Possessive case, like mine, yours, his, theirs. Okay. The second, that is relative pronoun. Relative pronoun join subordinate clauses to antecedent. Example, who, whose, whom, which, that, etc. The third, that is interrogative pronoun. Interrogative pronoun replace noun in question. Example, who, whose, whom, with, that. Okay. The fourth, that is demonstrative pronoun. Demonstrative pronoun, okay, demonstrative pronoun is specific the person or things. Example, this, that, those. The fifth, indefinite pronoun. It replaces pronoun like everyone, anyone, someone, everybody. Like when I greet you, good morning, everybody. So everybody there, it replaces the noun to replace you. To replace, for example, the men and the ladies, the audience. So we use this, okay? Indefinite pronoun. Six, that's reflexive pronoun. Reflexive pronoun emphasize or reflect an antecedent. Example, myself, yourself, himself, herself, etc. And the last type, that is reciprocal pronoun. Reciprocal pronoun, it indicates mutual relationship, like each other, one another, yeah, like this, okay? We come to the next slide. The third, the eighth part of speech, that is verb, okay? Verb expresses an action. expresses an occurrence and state of being. Okay, look at the first example. Here, the verb express an action. Alexa created an innovative advertising campaign. So created here, that's an action. Now the second. The winter holiday and the fall semester. So the end here, you mean the occurrence. And the third example, Ju is the new technical writer. Is here, that's the state of being. Okay, so let us continue. What's that? In relation to subject, so verb fall into three categories. The first that is action verb. Okay. The second that is linking verb. And the third that is helping verb. Now let us see the first one. Action verb. What do you know about action verb? So action verb tells what the subject does, including physical action and mental action. What do we know about physical action? This is the example. Naomi prepares the breakfast every day. So prepare, that is the physical action. Now we come to another example. Naomi dreams of buying new car. This is mental action, dream. Yeah, mental action. Next. Yeah, the second, that is linking verb. Linking verb tells a subject's state of being, like is, are, was, were, be, being, and then the senses like appear, smell, seem, taste, look, etc. Look at the example. The new employee is very responsible. Is the linking verb, yeah? State of being. The next example, the new employee looks very responsible. So looks here, that is the linking verb, using the senses, using the six senses of us, yeah? Six senses of us, you can see, you can smell, you can hear, you can taste, okay? And the third, that is helping verb. What is it, helping verb? So helping verb are added to a main verb to create a verb phrase. That is, am, are, was, were, be, being, have, has, had, should, would, will, and some others helping verbs. Now we see the example. Which one is the helping verb? John is working late. So we put the helping verb here to create the verb phrase. So verb phrase here is. So is the linking verb. Actually, we already have the verb here, working. We already have the verb here. But we put it here to create the verb phrase. Okay? Now the second example. John must be tired. Yeah? So, the helping verb here, that is be. Yeah, actually, must, that's already the verb. So that's why we have two or more than two verbs to create verb phrase. Okay, continue. Now, the verb that express an action can be divided into two categories. The first, we call it transitive. The second, we call it intransitive. Yeah? Transitive means this verb, yeah, need an object. Yeah? So this verb need an object to make the sentence meaningful. See the example. Krishna sells donut by the millions. So here, donut, that's the object. Yeah, so sell, that's the transitive verb that need an object for meaningful, yeah, for the meaningful sentence. The second, that is intransitive. Intransitive means, so when the action is complete in itself, yeah, the verb or the action is complete in itself and it requires no object. See the example here. Francisca listened carefully to the instructor. Stan dreams of opening his own bakery business of her one day. Yeah. So here, listen, that's the finished action already. It requires no object. Careful here. Careful, that's the adverb. That's not the object of the sentence. The same like this, Stan dreams of opening his own bakery, blah, 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 blah. So of opening, that's not the object, but that's the object of the preposition of the sentence. That's not the object, okay? Yeah, as we know, intransitive require no object. It's already complete the action. Okay, next. The next part of speech, that is adjective. Adjective describe or limit noun and pronoun. Adjective often answer the question, what kind, how many, which one. See here. Yellow walls in homes and offices are cheerful. Small independent business are becoming numerous. Yeah. So the blue one, yellow, cheerful, small, independent, numerous, those are adjective. So as you know, yeah, in one sentence, we may use more than one adjective, yeah, to make the sentence more sophisticated and more clear. Okay, you have to try to think about this. Okay, the next part of speech that is that is the adverb. That is the adverb. Okay. Adverb usually describe or limit verbs. So we use the adverb to limit the verb, limit the adjective and other verbs. Some adverbs form by adding ly. Yeah, ly to the adjective. You may see the example like efficient, and then you put ly, efficiently. Okay. Some other adverb, yeah, not added with ly, such as here, there, seldom, often, always, today, tomorrow, to, still, etc., and so many other adverb. Okay. Now, ma'am, have to tell you. Yeah, I have to tell you. There are three kinds of adverb. We have adverb of time, adverb of manner, and adverb of place. Okay? Yeah, let us see here the example. Listen carefully to the direction. So carefully, that's the adverb used here. This is the kind of adverb of manner. The second example, you may dial us directly. Yeah, the same. This is adverb of manner, directly. Carefully. Okay, we continue. The next part of speech that is preposition. So what is the function of preposition? So preposition connecting word. Yeah, they connect one sentence. Yeah, it is not complete if you don't use these to connect them, to link them. It may consist of one or more than one word. Yeah, we see this one. We have about, above, below, beside, after. That's for the one word. Now we have more than one word like according to, in spite of, in addition to. Okay, yeah, and some other. I think you have noticed. Okay, let us see the example to make it clear for you. Some of our greatest innovations were launched during tough time. So the preposition here, that is of, yeah, then during Okay. The next example. The most important ideas in business were developed over the past 100 years. In over, that's the preposition used in this sentence. Okay, next. So after the preposition, we will learn about conjunction. Yeah, you have to know about this. Yeah, we have some kind of conjunction. There are four, okay? There are four kind of conjunction. The first step is coordinating conjunction. Coordinating conjunction, they connect word, they connect phrases and clauses of equal grammatical value. Yeah, the most common coordinating conjunction are and, or, but, and nor. Okay, we see the example. The qualities I admire most, the qualities I admire most are honesty, integrity, and reliability. So we use coordinating conjunction and here. Okay. The second example. Gasoline prices are falling, but college tuition costs are rising. Yeah. Here we use but, yeah, the coordinating conjunction but. Other coordinating conjunction are yet, for, and so. Yeah, let us see the example. We use email extensively, yet we still prefer personal contact with our customer. Yeah, so yet here, that's the coordinating conjunction. The next example, the weary traveler was gone and ill, for his journey has been long and arduous. Yeah, so we use for here to connect this, to connect, to make this sentence meaningful. Continue, let us see the next conjunction. That is conjunctive adverb, yeah. Conjunctive adverb. Conjunctive adverb may also use to connect equal sentence elements. The most common conjunctive adverb are accordingly, also, anyway, consequently, furthermore, and, however, on the contrary, etc. Now we see the example. Some companies oppose the use of social networking. However, other companies find it encourages team collaboration and knowledge sharing. The second example, Sarah did her best, nevertheless, she did not pass her CPA exam the first time. Okay, so nevertheless, however, here are the conjunction adverb we use. The next kind of conjunction, that is correlative conjunction. Okay, correlative conjunction, like coordinating conjunction and conjunctive adverb, it join grammatically sentence elements. It uses in pairs. It uses in pair, the example like both and not. Okay. Not only, either or, neither nor. Okay, to make it clear, we see the example. Japo offers not only excellent customer service, but also a wise company policy. Yeah, so we use here not only and but. The second example. Your best chances are either in marketing department or in sales department. So either or. Yeah, either or. Okay, we continue. Subordinating conjunction. The next slide. Subordinating conjunction. to join unequal sentence elements. Yeah, the previous one we have learned to join the equal sentence element, but subordinating conjunction, we use this to join unequal sentence elements, such as dependent and independent clauses. Dependent clauses are often introduced by subordinating conjunctions, such as if, when, because, yeah, as, after, although, as if, until, since, whether, and some others. Let us see the example. Sometimes, if there's no example, maybe you feel it's not clear. Okay, let us see this. Even though Pillow France were invented the television in 1927, he was never able to personally introduce it to customers. The second, if you are looking for an exciting career, so think about to be an actor. The third example, please call me if you have any question. Okay, so subordinating conjunction used here, that is, even though, if, yeah, if you are looking for an exciting career, then if you have any question. Okay, we come to the last part of speech, that is interjection. Okay, interjection, it expresses strong feelings. Interjection standing alone, yeah, are followed by exclamation mark. Example, ma'am prepared three examples here. Yeah. Whoa, did you see what she write in her email message? Whoa, and then it is ended by exclamation mark. Did you see what she write in her email message? So this interjection, standing alone, it can stand alone. So ended by exclamation mark. The next, well, I suggest that means the meeting is over. So well here, this is the introduction that's woven into sentence. So we put comma because they join in a sentence. Yeah, we just put comma. The same like the last. Oh, I certainly will submit a resume and application to them. They woven in a sentence. So just followed by comma. Okay, the next. Yeah, because we want to know more how to learn grammar, okay? How to learn grammar through group project of animated video and class discussion. Okay. Despite its significance in language learning, grammar has tended to be problematic. Yeah, why? Okay, why it become the problematic for us? Yeah, so the problematic also for teacher and for learner, yeah? Not only for the teacher, also for teacher and learners. In most cases, grammar taught in classroom is not successfully transfer its actual use in the outside world. And this is not guarantee the capability in using them. Larson Freeman, 2003, referred to the shortcoming above, stated that grammar teaching will be effective and useful when learners have also had the opportunity to encounter, to process, and use instructive form in the various form-meaning relationship so that the forms can become a part of their interlanguage behavior. The next, it is widely known that the use of technology has positive effect on learners, yeah, on learners' performance and gaining more skills. Okay. Animation as technological tool used in education has significant increase, yeah, in attitude and academic achievement. Yeah, you can see from this, okay, stated by Basak Baklama, I repeat once again, animation as technological tools used in education has significant increase in attitude and academic achievement, yeah, of the student in the positive way. Yeah, in a positive way. The next, it is the aid of moving many pictures and graphics into scenario and are created by linking consecutive images. Basak Baklama. So here we already discussed about the technology, about the animated video. Okay, the next. Video animation is a modern entertainment media, consists of moving pictures, text, graphic, integrated with sound and voice. Valentinus Yoga. So this video can encourage class actively engage, also help learners to retain information, introduce new vocabulary, learning grammar, message, yeah, to send a message, a moral, and entertainment at the same time. Yeah, maybe last time we just see what's that, the movie animated video only just to entertain us, just to make you happy without the academic achievement there. But now, because of the technology, we may integrate them. Yeah, we may integrate them. You may learn every kind of skill. Yeah, every kind of skill for the speaking, for the grammar. We integrated that with the technology. This new technology have helped learners as well as teacher, yeah, to make classroom language learning more active and efficient. Jari Saidi. So we have what's that? We may learn more effective and efficient, not only for the learners, but also for the instructor, for the teachers too. Next. The mode of teaching grammar with the help of visual and movie has been in practical use of teacher for teaching any language for years. The objective of teaching and learning through motion picture are to build up interpretation, listening, speaking, grammar, also vocabulary skill of any language, as well as can be extremely inspiring, yeah, and thought provoking, and can make language learning more pleasant, yeah, more enjoyable. The creation of an animated video clip as assignment for a class project present an opportunity for learner to be engaged in their own learning process, and that it may motivate them to invest in the learning process. As we know, this is a group project, so they will come together, they do the social present, they interact, yeah, with the classmate. So of course this may motivate them, yeah. Okay. The assignment offer an opportunity, yeah, as already explained before. So it gives an opportunity to hold students accountable for content mastery in an interactive way. Then consider as post learning experience that present content mastery. Okay, class. So this is, yeah, we as a teacher, lecturers, instructor, so we have to think about this, the group project, because by offering this group project, it may hold students accountable for the content mastery in an interactive way. Yeah, it has two ways of learning, positive way of learning, not just the teacher deliver the material, just one side of the learning. Okay. Okay, we continue. In giving this in giving this group project of animated video, so we have some criteria. Yeah, there are 7 descriptors to be considered to evaluate the final animated video. The first, that is knowledge of content. The second, the organization or presentation of content, alignment with learning outcomes, animation clips, personality, audience specific, and grammar. Yeah, so we may, we as a teacher may assign this, we may offer this group project for our learners, but we have to think about this 7 descriptor. Knowledge of content, organization, or presentation of content, alignment with learning outcome. Alignment with learning outcome, it means that it is matched with the material that we have discussed. Like today, I want to evaluate my students' grammar mastery using this animated video. Yeah, so we have something that we want to get. Not only ask them to make, okay, student, let me give you a task. You have to make a project. This is a group project, make an animated video, but we don't have any benefit there. But here, we have something, the academic outcome. So that's why the video must be alignment with the learning outcomes. Okay, let us see what do we mean by knowledge of content. The next slide. The first that is from the 7 descriptor, the first that is knowledge of content. The assignment, the assignment is connected to academic outcomes. Then learners are required to present the desired outcome. This animated video clip is simply the vehicle for delivering an idea via a visual media channel. Okay, so as I already explained to you that this assignment is connected to the academic outcome, then learners are required to present that, to include that, in the desired content. And this animated video is only as the vehicle for delivering this via visual media channel. The next descriptor, that is organization or presentation of content. It presents logical and concise information, then it must be organized. So what they must do, that must be organized, from the first, second, the third, until the last, until the last, that must be organized. The next descriptor, alignment with learning outcomes. The animated clip will address the learning outcome via interactive animation. So this is the function of this animation. So we have the connection, we have to address this animated video with our learning outcomes via interactive animation. And the last, that is animation. Is it the last? First, second, third, the fourth. The fourth, that is animation. The focus of the assignment should be the academic content and not the production quality of the clip. But the animation clip can impact, enhance the delivery of content. So we focus to the academic content, not the production of the quality of the clip. But in fact, this may enhance learners, learners' academic achievement. Okay, the next slide. The next descriptor when we want to evaluate the final animated video. Personality. Students should create an interactive and dynamic clip in which accurate content information is presented in a unique way that the audience will not forget. So how we make the audience a view an entertainment that unforgettable one. Yeah, so we try to create this. How we motivate, how we guide our student, yeah, to create an interactive dynamic clips, yeah, that present an information. And the audience will remember this. Okay. The next description that is audience-specific. Audience-specific. Similar to other form of communication, it is important to recognize that the video clip should target a specific audience rather than just the general audience. Specific audience here, yeah, it means not only the student, but the people who are make something benefits from this. Yeah, can be the student, can be the teacher, lecturers. Okay, so they may get something important. What's that message? The message there convey in this animated video. And the last that is grammar. So the use of proper grammar throughout the video clip should be important to be considered. Yeah, of this academic assignment. So maybe there's a connection with the previous descriptor that we not just focus on the production of the clip, but we have to know about the academic assignment, the grammar. Yeah, so we have to think about the grammar used, like we have learned before, the 8 part of speech. That's why in this workshop, so I try to familiarize to you about the 8 part of speech. Actually, you have learned this, you know about this, but maybe you don't know the term. This is so basic, yeah, the basic of your English knowledge. Okay, the next. Okay, now let us see, yeah, what kind of animated video will be over here. There are some animated softwares over such as Protagon, Moviestorm, Go, yeah, Go Animate, Animoom, Animaker, and some other interesting animated softwares. But here in this my workshop, I want to familiarize. I want to introduce Protagon software. Yeah, Protagon software is the extremely user friendly and cost effective. User friendly here, meaning that the beginner can try, yeah, it's easy for them, not difficult, it's friendly for you, it's easy to be used. The Protagon software, yeah, it's introduced to the public in August 2013. It allows user to select a scene, character, a location for its character, as well as apply different character movement. Okay, Rahel Grafik. So this Protagon software, it offer for you, it introduce for you, so you may select the scene, the character, so which character you want to use in your video, and then you may you may use some accessories for them about the clutch, maybe the trouser, the glasses, the color of the hair, the color of the skin. So we have that. Okay, next, let us see more how to use this, how to use this software, how to create this animated video. Okay, the first, we have the step here. Log onto the site, yeah, the site www.protagon.com. You have to create an account, then you are prompted to download the Protagon software using your laptop. The second step, yeah, you have to give an original title to this clip, to your animated video clip. Then select the scene, characters, character location, and movement. The third step, create the conversation for the authors. So for this, for the dialogue conversation, you may type them. Yeah, you may type them. So we have the sound from the artificial intelligence. So they will imitate. Yeah, they will create the dialogue based on what we are typing in the text, or you may record your own voice. Yeah, we can record our own voice. The next step, adding some animation effect such as an action, movement, sound, text, or music. And then the last, once it is completed, learners are prompted to publish their clips. You may publish that through some media, maybe WhatsApp or YouTube channel. Yeah, that's up to you. Okay, the next. In creating this using Plotagon, you may use your smartphone too. That's easier. That's easier than using the laptop. You may create this everywhere, anywhere as you want. Yeah, you may create a wonderful, awesome video. Okay, let us see here. You may install the Plotagon software in your smartphone through Play Store. Yeah, it's simpler than using laptop. You may create a wonderful video anywhere, anytime as you want. Yeah, no reason not to create this. And then, the same like the previous one, as I already said that it offered the scenes, characters, facial expression, accessories, voice, language, you can use English, Indonesia, or Chinese, so many others. Based on what kind of video using what language. Yeah, that's amazing. Okay, next. The character provided there can be created, yeah, can be created or can be bought, yeah. As well as the accessories, you may buy that. But actually, we have the free one, you can use it. But if you want to make more wonderful clips, you can buy, yeah, you can buy. Yeah, okay, as a teacher, there are at least two considerations, yeah, that you have to discuss this with your student. There are two considerations. The first, that is the cost. Depending on the company, yeah, depending on the software company and its product, so there could be a cost associated with creating and publishing these animated clips. The next consideration, that is over-animating. Teacher should be mindful that they integrated this animation assignment into their courses, into their class. Yeah, this animated clip should have positive effects on students' learning, and teachers should be careful not to over-animate. Yeah, not to over-animate. So teachers have to know about this, because sometimes, we are not concerned about the descriptor to be evaluated. So this can be for us consideration to think about. Over animate, what does it mean? It means this animated clip should not be the only means of assessment within the learning process, within the instructional process. This video clip reinforces a different set of abilities and skills that match the overall course learning outcome. Yeah? So, okay, we may have teaching learning process like the usual one, Okay, and then we give the project for them, yeah, to create different set of abilities and skill. So not focus on this project. So it means that by giving this assignment, so learners can be able to master this lesson, for example. No, but yeah, so a teacher should be mindful about this. Yeah, this video or this assignment just different set of abilities. Yeah, to create different set of abilities and skill. Okay, the next slide. Based on the title, so we have the discussion class, learning grammar through group project of animated video and class discussion. Discussion, class discussion here mean, yeah, so this is as a much as a method of instructor, much of the literature on language in classroom focuses. Yeah, so this method of discussion become the focus of the learners. Okay, as a method of discussion, it provides an approach for teaching content, while as outcome or goal instruction, it emphasizes that students become competent discussers. Yeah, by having this class discussion, this method, learning method, we hope that, yeah, students, they may become the competent discussant. The next expert, Mercer and Ho, 2012, conclude that when teachers actively engage learners in reflective discussion of what they are studying, so this help learner develop their understanding and prepare them well for independent learning. Yeah, so by using this method of learning, it may prepare the learners to be the independent learning. Yeah, to be the independent learning and then have the skill, the competence to be the competent discussant. Aligned with this, several studies have shown that discussion, whether that's in the whole discussion or group discussion and in pairs, they can promote students' learnings and understanding. This method of discussion, yeah? So the benefit of this, it may promote students' learning and understanding to the lesson, to the material. Okay, next. Okay, we still discuss what is discussion about the, what is the benefit of this for our class. Class discussion is carried out after each group display their project, their animated clips. Okay, the members of each group have to responsible of the clips, such as the process, the content, and the grammar applied in the dialogue, in the conversation. Each member is prompted to deliver what their contribution are in the group project. So they have to responsible for this. Yeah, so they have to be active to come for the meeting, discussing of this group project. They have to responsible how to create sentences using the precise grammar or grammatically correct. Okay. Next, actually, yeah, in producing this clip, this group project, learners are guided. Yeah, so we have to guide them in each meeting to check about their readiness, about their collaboration, yeah, cooperation. Also, the hindrances, the obstacle encounter while making these clips until it is finished and enjoyed by the class. Okay, the next. We come to the previous result. Of course, I can make this workshop because we have the previous research to support my data. Okay, we see this one. Animation is indeed a valuable tool to explain difficult practices in medicine, especially in teaching complicated issue. Yeah, so if we as a teacher think that it's so rather hard how to deliver, how to convey this to our student, so we can try to use this animated video. Yeah, so it may help us to explain the difficult one, yeah, the complicated, especially in medicine. The next expert, Chelsea Liu and Philip, 2019, in their study concluded that animated instructional video enrich learners' education understanding, such as the higher involvement, attention, increase the understanding, and better flexibility, yeah, in the independent learning. Also, it presents precious guidance to empower the next instructor to utilize the strengths of graphic animated technology to create useful teaching access. Yeah, access, okay? Yeah, this is according to the expert that support my study. The next, that is similar with what already mentioned by them, Destrianti, Sudaryono, and Diana, 2019. The goal of animation implemented in our teaching to decrease the boring and passive learning atmosphere, okay? And to create the interactive between teacher and learner, interactive learning process. Okay, next, Imam Fauzi, 2017, said like in his research outcome that learner speaking competence should be improved effectively through group project, through group small discussion, involve them in group working dynamically, foster them to be self-reliant, okay? And then who are involved themselves in learning activities, to create a greater comfortable education situation. It may provide changes for learners to enhance their communication ability. Okay, now let us see the next slide. Okay, here I try to display to make it easier for you. Maybe you can download how to make this. So after you download, so you have this like this. So you create the video. Okay. Then we have the title. You may see some location for that. You may give the title here. At the cafe, if you see this, yeah, at the cafe, here at the living room, here at the corner, and some other location, some other scene provided there. Okay, we see the next picture. For the characters, you may create, yeah. Actually, we have some character already provided there, but you can also create, yeah, by your own. If you want to have another one, you can create here. This one that already created by me, I give the name. If there are some correction, you may click this pencil to do the correction for the name, can be. Okay, the next picture. Here are the characters that already created. You may see some accessories like the face, hair. Here is the mustache when it is for the male. Here is the eyes. Maybe you want to have the blue eyes, brown eyes. Okay. And then the properties like glasses. Oh, yeah, some other shoes, maybe bag, yeah. Yeah, the clothes. Now you can change the clothes. For the formal one, informal one, just use t-shirt, the trousers, some others. It is over there in this software, Protagon software. This for the female one, yeah, you may change the hair. You may change the hair to be the female one. Yeah, or that's the male. And then here we have randomize. Randomize, it means that this software create for you. So if you agree with the creation, you can click randomize again and that stop. So I mean, you agree that's characters. But if not, you can create by yourself, female or male with their accessories or properties. Okay. Beside here, we have another picture. This is the information for you. This is for the facial expression. We have super exciting surprise. Yeah. So the character when they are to show the surprise, yeah, you can click here surprise expression, facial expression, suspicious. Yeah, you can click that and the character will show like as you want. Talk to the hand when you say thank you. How about your face expression? Thinking while you are thinking, maybe you put your hand, yeah, on your head and try to think. Yeah, so we have the facial. They are offering some facial expression here. Yeah. Thinking, threatening, you are in a dangerous situation. Okay, waving, whispering, winking, and some other. What's that? Match with the video, match with the situation that you want. Okay, the next. Okay, here. I try to make a dialogue, and this dialogue, this is a dialogue for my animated video. So I try to make my own animated video. So as we know, you have to concern about the grammar used there. That must be grammatical. Maybe you can think about the 8 part of speech that we have learned. Okay, the use of noun, pronoun, adverb, verb, preposition, conjunction, interjection. Okay. This is not only for teacher, I think student, yeah, this is really a good opportunity for you. You may create your own video. After that, you can publish that, yeah. You try to deliver, you try to confess something, yeah, using this animated video. Not only to entertain us, but you may get something. You try to, what's that, send a message there, send a moral. Okay, yeah, this is a good one. Yeah, okay, let us see the video that already created by me. Okay,
saya stop share ya berarti ya.
Iya, yeah.
Oke, okay.
Please share it, Anthony. Okay, maybe I can share it. I try to share it, Anthony.
Okay, no problem.
Okay. Wow, the problem with this, maybe still cannot, Anthony. Maybe I have to wait. I have to send this video again.
Okay, man. You can try send it to me, and I'll.
Yeah, I try to send it to you.
Okay. Okay.
Yeah, the new one. Okay. The new one. Wait.
Untuk PPT-nya boleh di-share juga, Mem.
Okay.
Ke kolom chat ya.
Okay. Hopefully, yeah. This workshop, you may get something from this workshop by creating your own characters. Yeah, you will feel satisfied. Yeah, and then of course, this is make your lesson, your class more interactive and interesting. Yeah.
Selagi menunggu ya.
Yeah.
Dari yang saya tangkap dari sini ternyata materinya ini cukup menarik ya. Dimana kita animasi itu bukan hanya sekedar hiburan ya. Dimana animasi juga bisa menjadi sebuah platform dari pembelajaran dan tentu saja menjadi cukup menarik ya untuk menggunakan platform animasi. Dimana anak-anak muda mungkin ya. Kalau saya sendiri itu kalau membaca itu nggak terlalu suka ya. Kalau lihat video apalagi animasi itu suka banget. Nah, terus untuk platform dari Plotagon ini, saya kemarin ada coba juga ya. Dalam pencobaannya, ternyata simple sekali dalam penggunaan aplikasinya, di mana tinggal download, dan kalau saya tidak salah ya, saya tidak perlu login ke akun ya kalau di mobile ya. Maaf ya kalau saya salah ya. Tapi ketika saya buka, itu langsung ada create ya. Kita tinggal masukin room, kita juga bisa desain-desain karakter di sana. Nah, desain-desain karakternya itu kayak game loh, seolah-olah kayak game. Seru. Benaran, serius. Jadi kita bisa desain, misalnya perempuan atau laki-laki, kemudian rambutnya kita desain terserah kita, punya aksesorisnya terserah kita. Nah, jadi tinggal diinteraksiin aja, tinggal diobrolin aja, gampang banget dalam penggunaan aplikasinya. Nah, teman-teman kalau nggak percaya bisa coba di-download ya. Aplikasinya Plotagon itu ada di Play Store ya. Barangkali untuk media pendidikan atau mungkin teman-teman pada ingin upload ke sebuah platform untuk konten ya, itu juga bisa. Harganya juga saya kemarin juga ada itu ya cukup terjangkau ya. Kalau kita pertama kali pakai, itu aplikasinya kasih free gratis 3 hari. Ya, jadi kita bisa coba-coba dulu kayak demo gitu lah ya. Nah, kalau misalkan udah 3 hari lewat, itu kita bisa terusin lagi ya kalau kita mau yang berbayar. Itu cukup murah, di mana, nah di sini ya, saya bukakan. Nah, ini saya punya aplikasinya. Nah, aplikasinya untuk trial day, 3 hari ya, itu bronze, itu namanya bronze. itu harganya Rp7 saja. Dan dalam 3 hari itu bisa buat video lumayan banyak kalau teman-teman pada rajin ya. Saya juga ada coba create video, itu 1 menit ya, iseng ya. Itu 1 menit lebih gitu durasinya. Dan video itu create-nya bentar, cuma 15-30 menit. Udah selesai, saking simpelnya. Nah, kemudian ada, kalau teman-teman memang mau lebih premium ya, ada yang lain juga sih. Misalnya 20.000 per month atau 35.000 per month juga ada. Ya, tergantung dengan kebutuhan masing-masing dari teman-teman lah ya. Oke, kembali ke Mem Susanti, apakah sudah bisa ya? Halo, Mem.
Coba yang udah dikirim, apa yang udah dikirim ke Anthony, coba Anthony please send it. Yeah, you can replay that. Maybe Mem have the problem with the connection.
Yang mana ya, Mem ya? Yang pertama kali saya kirim ke Mem atau yang?
Iya, boleh yang pertama kali itu boleh.
Oh, yang punya saya ya. Yeah. Oke. Okay.
Yang sudah Mem kirim kemarin kan?
Ini agak, kalau misalnya bahasa Inggrisnya agak jelek ya, sudahlah ya. Saya juga masih belajar. Nah, bentar, saya download dulu. Oke. Bentar ya. Saya share screen. Nah, bisa dilihat. Halo, Mem. Bisa dilihat nih, Mem. Teman-teman. Ana. Screen-nya bisa dilihat.
Ya, oke. Okay. Ya, Anthony. Yeah, this is a video. Okay, please enjoy this. This is the class situation, ya. Yeah? This is the class situation between the teacher and the student. Okay, please enjoy this. Actually, yeah, this is a nice conversation. Okay, yeah, please enjoy this.
Okay. Bentar ya.
Good morning, everyone, both of you. As you all know, this is a remedial math class. This is because of your lack of studying and diligence. I hope we could learn something after this class ended. Now, I will start calling out your name, while you guys have to reply while telling me why did you fail your math. First, Jose.
I'm Jose, I failed math class because I used system kebut semalam. I spend all of my day playing a game rather than studying. Sorry, teach.
Next and the last, Miss Troublemaker Valerie.
Hello, teach. I'm here. I failed math because I don't like it. Why do I have to do such thing as math while I want to be a model?
Okay, thank you very much. First of all, Jose, even though you failed because of system kebut semalam, you're being honest and realize why you failed? Great. As for Valerie, that is a great question. What math have to do with modeling, right? Okay, it's maybe true you won't need this in the future. But, what I have to tell you guys is, this is all not for your score. But, for your responsibilities as a student, of course. You need responsibilities and you have to do it. We here, as a teacher, not only teaching about your subjects, but your behavior too. You could understand, right? The important thing is your responsibilities. You might need it in your future modeling career, of course.
You're right, teach. I'm sorry. I will try it.
Excellent. Now, let us start the class. Good morning, everyone.
Nah, jadi seperti itu ya videonya.
Oke. Okay. Ya. Yeah. Well, actually, class. Yeah, I have prepared 2 video. But because of unstable connection, but I've tried to, yeah, to ask the moderator to help me. Maybe, yeah, he can try to display it again because I have 2 videos. Have you received the videos from me? From the PPT. The video is in the PPT, the last page.
Oh, okay.
And then I know that the audience here, we have some teachers, okay? We have some teachers. Hopefully this is, I think not this one. I think not this one.
Okay.
Yeah, okay, but you can, yeah, you can play it. No problem. You can play it. Yeah, because sometimes because of unstable connection, yeah. Yeah, you can play that, Anthony. Thanks a lot.
Okay, ini videonya.
Hi Jimmy, how's it going?
Great. Thanks. And you?
Fine, thanks. Where are you going, Jim? You look in hurry. What's wrong?
I'm going to go to the library. I'll have English test next week and need to start studying.
Oh, no, is it English test? I think my class will have the English test too. I haven't prepared for it.
So, we can learn it together. How about at 5 o'clock at my cafe tomorrow?
At 5 o'clock at your cafe? Okay, I'll be there. By the way, I still cannot understand some exercises from Miss Annie. I hope we can discuss it together. Oh Jim, it's really a brilliant idea. Thanks for your kindness, friend.
That's okay, Faye. Hopefully both of us get satisfied scores. Believe me.
Okay. Yeah, so I try to create this video. And then I will apply this to my class. And then for the character class, as I told you already in the previous slide, yeah, it is already it's already provided there. But if you want to have the more awesome, satisfied character, you can buy that. Yeah, there are some way how to buy, how to subscribe the characters. Okay, yeah, of course. You have to consider about the cost. You may subscribe each month, each week, up to you. So as a teacher, we may try, like I already explained to you, in my class, I try to teach the 8th part of speech. That's the second chapter in my lesson. So I try to teach my student using this video. And when I see, yeah, of course, yeah, they respond, they are involved, they are engaged, yeah, watching these clips, yeah. And then this, their project, their own project. So the other group may give comment, yeah, whether they have the precise grammar, is it grammatically, yeah, and then the ideas. Yeah, so besides, we can learn, it's entertain us at the same time. This can be used for another lesson, not only for English, for teaching math, science, social science. Yeah, so we can try to use this. Hopefully, yeah, the class enjoy this, and then they may. What's that? Because that's something different from the previous one. This is can be the matter of that. The last, as I told you, we have the discussion class. Discussion class, how all the group, we discuss it together. Of course, the teacher to lead the discussion. Yeah. We can ask about the preparation. Can you so ask the grammar that you use in your sentence? So what ideas that you want to deliver to us? Yeah. Okay. Well, Anthony and Johanna. So I think that's about my presentation. Thank you.
Okay. Makasih, Mem, atas materinya. Gimana nih teman-teman dengan materi yang saya sampaikan? Apa sudah puas atau ada yang kurang jelas? Gimana nih Antoni?
Nah, berdasarkan dari PPT yang telah dipresentasikan oleh Mem Susanti, ini dapat kita lihat ya, ternyata bahasa Inggris itu juga nggak bisa dianggap remeh ya, sebuah bahasa ya. Di mana kita melihat di awal ya, ada penggunaan grammar, dan masih banyak lagi. Di mana yang saya lihat ya, tadi ada sebuah mengenai apa ya, bentar ya, saya buka dulu ya. Nah, ada nouns kan, ada common nouns. Ternyata noun itu bukan cuma satu. Nah, noun itu ada banyak, ada empat. Ada concrete noun, common noun, abstract noun, proper noun. Nah, kemudian ada verb juga ya. Nah, ternyata bahasa Inggris itu tidak segampang yang mungkin teman-teman kira ya. Dan juga tidak sesulit itu. Jika teman-teman memang meluangkan waktunya, dan jika teman-teman mau belajar, itu sangat mudah. Kalau mau belajar ya.
Nah, ya, betul.
Nah, kalau menurut Hana nih,
ya,
penggunaan dari animasi dalam pembelajaran itu bagaimana ya? Sebagai mahasiswa gitu.
Kalau menurut aku sih, seru banget sih. Soalnya kan aku lebih suka video daripada materi gitu ya, kayak baca-baca gitu. Kalau untuk, apalagi untuk anak SD, SMP gitu kan paling suka lihat video daripada baca kan. Gitu, jadi menurut
ya,
aku tuh
benar.
Iya, aku suka.
Nah, berarti Hana ada coba gak aplikasinya? Belum ya?
Oh, belum coba sih, tapi nah, OTW coba.
Nanti coba belajar itu, waduh, itu gampang banget loh dalam
gampang,
pengoperasian
ya,
aplikasinya.
Katanya nah, kamu cuma 15 menit buat video.
Iya, benar.
Iya.
Dalam downloadnya juga agak besar ya, dalam pemakaian memorinya. Paling mungkin setelah videonya jadi, mungkin agak besar ya. Nggak tahu, tergantung durasi videonya juga. Nah, bentar ya.
Oh iya, kita bakalan buka sesi tanya-jawab juga ya. Enggak sih. Tapi kita buka cuma 4 soal pertanyaan. Ya nggak, Anthony?
Nah iya, benar sekali. Nah, dengan pertanyaan-pertanyaan tersebut, mungkin dari teman-teman ingin mengajukannya. Nah, boleh dong di kolom chat ya, kalian mengajukan pertanyaannya. Nah, karena ini limited untuk 4 saja ya, karena kita mungkin bisa lebih juga, tergantung lah ya. Gimana, Mem? Untuk pertanyaannya, Mem?
Sementara 4 dulu.
4 ya, dulu ya, Mem, ya. Oke. Okay. Nah, silakan
ya,
langsung ketik di komentar, ketik Rex pasti, waduh. Ya, ayo, barangkali ada teman-teman yang bingung gitu, ada mau nanya. Sampai ada yang PC loh, Adi, mana Adi? Waduh.
Aduh,
Adi. Semangatnya dia nih. Ya, teman-teman ya, yang mau bertanya silahkan langsung di kolom chat.
Yuk cepat yuk, 4 orang beruntung aja.
Mungkin ada dapat hadiah kan? Saya nggak tahu lah ya. Nggak, bercanda.
Itu ada yang chat sih.
Oh, lagi di mute ya? Bentar ya. Nah, barangkali ini gimana ya? Nggak bisa di unmute ya?
Bisa itu. Coba.
Nah, udah coba bisa sekarang?
Akhirnya saya bisa ngomong.
Nah, siap.
Dipanggil-panggil tapi nggak bisa ngomong kan, ya gimana juga.
Aduh, boleh perkenalan dulu, Bang?
Janganlah ya.
Waduh. Kalian juga lah IG-nya barangkali. Promosi.
Ntar famous.
Yuk,
ya, buat teman-teman yang mau nanya-nanya, tentang materi tadi, bahkan di luar materi tadi juga dipersilahkan ya.
Di dalam materi dong.
Ya. Di luar materi tapi berkaitan dengan bahasa Inggris kan, ya apa-apa.
Apa pertanyaannya? Silahkan.
Saya ngambil yang belakangan aja, Bang, gak apa-apa.
Duluan aja, Bang.
Ayo, ayo.
Ayo dong, Bang.
Nah, dalam Adi ini kan saya tahu nih salah satu peserta kita ini, saya kan kenal dia ya. Dia tuh bisa editing ya, desain-desain grafis ya.
Iya,
nah,
kayaknya sih editor gitu ya.
Iya, kayak editor-editor gitu. Nah, bagaimana pendapat Abang Adi coba? Apakah Abang Adi ini tentang animasi ini gimana, Bang Adi?
Oke, jadi benar yang dikatain tadi ya. Saya itu salah satu konten kreator dari perusahaan ya lumayan. Nah, jadi dengan adanya aplikasi ini sebenarnya sangat mudah kita dalam proses produksi, karena untuk saya pribadi untuk memproduksi animasi, apalagi ini kan udah kelasnya udah 3 dimensi ya. Nah, untuk animasi 3 dimensi ini proses produksinya itu paling singkat dalam waktu kurang lebih 1 minggu sampai 2 minggu. Itu untuk animasi sederhana di durasi kurang lebih 1 sampai 2 menit. Nah, seperti itu. Dengan adanya aplikasi ini sangat mempermudah sekali nih, karena seperti yang udah jelaskan tadi, kayak udah karakternya udah ada, environment-nya juga udah ada, lalu kita juga bisa nginput suara dan lain-lain. Ini aplikasi yang udah okay sih gitu kan. Nah, untuk fitur-fiturnya juga, kalaupun berlangganan premium, rasanya juga nggak terlalu mahal-mahal amat ya, karena harga segitu dengan yang okay gitu kan, itu udah lumayan murah banget kita yang main aplikasi yang harganya wah lah gitu. Itu aja sih kalau untuk dari aplikasi.
Nah, okay, terima kasih dari Bang Adi Saputra atas pendapatnya. Nah, kita udah dapat dua pertanyaan nih langsung nih. Nah, pertama dari Kak Febriana Chen. Nah, kelemahan dari aplikasi tersebut itu apa dan resiko untung ruginya? Nah, bagaimana nih dari teman-teman nih? Nah, kalau menurut saya ya, dalam aplikasi ini, kelemahan itu semua aplikasi pasti ada ya. Tapi dari pengalaman yang saya coba, itu untuk pertama untuk orangnya ya, kalau misalnya lebih dari 2 di satu room, itu nggak bisa ditampilin tiga-tiganya secara langsung. Dalam arti misalnya satu ruangan, dia tuh nggak bisa view langsung 3 orang. Jadi itu satu orangnya terpisah. Nah, kalau perlu saya kasih contoh ya, saya kasih contoh dulu di video saya. Nah, teman-teman bisa lihat ya.
You all know, this is a remedial math class. This is because of your lack of studying and diligence. I hope we could learn something after this class ended. Now, I will start calling out your name, while you guys have to reply while telling me why did you fail your math. First, Jose.
I'm Jose, I failed math class because I used system que boot se malam. I spend all of my day playing a game rather than studying. Sorry, teach.
Next and the last. Miss Troublemaker Valerie.
Hello teach. I'm.
Nah, di sini kita bisa lihat ya.
Anthony.
Ini pertama. Oh iya, ma'am.
Mungkin ma'am mau menambahkan.
Oh, oke, ma'am, silakan, ma'am.
Yeah. Let me try to add something. Ya. Yeah. Jadi dari video ini, dari dua video yang udah kita tampilkan, from these two videos that already display for you, we have the question from who? Anthony, from whom?
Febriana. Ayo, okay. Febriana.
The question that is about the weaknesses. About the weaknesses of this video, that's for the first question. And then the second question about, the profit that we may get. Or the loss that we may get from this video, answer for this. Yeah, I think maybe what already mentioned by Anthony, yeah, we have something, it's right, that's right. Maybe this is one of the weaknesses of this software. But actually we can buy, yeah? We can buy, we have some extra. When you make this, so we have some application, you can click that for the extra people. Yeah, for the extra people. So like the video, the first video, the teacher, and then we have two students, okay? Two students. Actually, we have the button, you can click that. So we may have extra people. We may have extra people. You will see that, for example, in the classroom, you can see that in the classroom, the people there, but maybe they are not interact with the others. They just, for example, sit down. But the active one, like the teacher, and then the boy and Valeria, yeah? Jose, Valeria, the teacher, okay, they can interact each other. You may add another extra people, like the other student who are sitting on the chair, but they are not, but maybe they cannot interact, but if you want, yeah, we can try to make it. I think you are intelligent, so we can buy some character to join in this video. Yeah, so that's the first question. I already answered that. And then for the second question, okay, still from Fabriana. Like we already discussed, that depends on the teacher itself. If you want to make your class more interesting, more dynamic, so you can try to apply this. Yeah, I don't insist you, but this is for my class. I try to apply this. I want to make something different from the previous one. Maybe for the previous one, I just teach them, okay? I just teach them and then I just display the PPT and I will ask them to read or to listen to the song or they practice singing. But now we get something different from the previous one. They have the group project, how they integrate it with the technology. As you know, you are the young generation, you are the millennial one. This is easy for you, how to create that, how to mix your ideas in your dialogue, okay? And then, yeah, become a wonderful, awesome clips. Yeah, that's the question from me. Fabriana?
Okay. Bye, Fabriana.
Okay. I'm ready, ma'am.
Nah, ada pertanyaan juga nih, ma'am. Dari Bang Aloysius. Apa sih yang membuat video pembelajaran lebih menarik dari metode pembelajaran yang lain? Gimana, ma'am?
Ya. Yeah. That I already told to you. Maybe this is different from the previous one. Ya. Yeah. Last time, I just teach my class. Okay, I have to repeat this. So last time I just teach the class, I come to the classroom, I greet them, hello, hi ma'am, how are you, how is life, it's great, it's fine, okay, yeah, and maybe, yeah, this is happen, always happen like this. I try to teach them using the PPT, yeah, and then maybe this will make our student bored about this, that's what I try to think. Yeah, because as a teacher, we have to responsible about the student score, the academic achievement. So that's why we apply this. Yeah, how they try to make, how they involve in the process. Yeah, how they make the dialogue, the use of the 8 part of speech apply in their dialogue. So they have to think about this. They have to concern about this. Yeah. Yeah, of course, the result, they will have a good comprehension, a good mastery about the lesson that we have learned. Yeah, via the animated clips like this. Yeah, I think that's enough for my explanation.
Oh, yeah, ma'am, okay. Mana nih Abang Aloysius-nya? Gimana, Bang? Udah ngerti belum? Boleh dong di open cam-nya.
Ya nih, mumpung dapat kesempatan untuk ngomong dengan kakaknya nih, waduh. Yo.
Oh, dia di chat langsung ya. Sudah, Kak, katanya. Gak mau open cam dulu, Bang. Oke, boleh lanjut ke pertanyaan ketiga kali ya, Antonia.
Mungkin enggak ya. Oke. Silakan dilanjutkan coba untuk Kak Yohana.
Pertanyaan
lanjut
ketiga ya.
Yang pertanyaan selanjutnya coba dibacain. Iya, benar.
Oke, pertanyaan ketiga. Pertanyaannya tuh gimana caranya membuat video pembelajaran agar lebih menarik dan dapat dipahami? Gimana? Dia bisa bantu enggak? Kalau menurut
namanya,
aku sih dari gambar-gambar ya.
Waduh, namanya angka doang nih.
Iya, namanya angka doang, nggak bisa dipanggil ya.
Oke, okay. Let me try to create this. Let me try to answer this. So maybe you can try to download this. Download, and then you can see maybe the tutorial to help you. The tutorial from the YouTube to help you how to create the more awesome video. Animated video clips, yeah, to make it more wonderful. Yeah, you have to know some step. The first from select the scene. There are many scenes provided there. Maybe at the cafe, yeah, at the cafe, in the classroom, at the cafe, in the dining room. You may select that, yeah. You may decide which one you want to choose. Okay, and then the characters you can choose them. As I told you, you may subscribe, you may buy for more wonderful characters. But for the beginner, yeah, for the beginner, maybe you can try to use the character that already provided there. Yeah, we have the character of provided there, and then you can change. You may add some more accessories like the hair. Maybe the color of the hair, the color of the skin, yeah, the size of the eyes, and then about the facial expression while you are angry. So your animated video will show that. So the artificial intelligence will record that. And then for the sound, so I think this is will more interesting. Yeah, if you record your own sound. So as a the task for the group project, there are 5 students, so they can record their own sound, not using the robot sound from this. Yeah, so this can make the wonderful clips for you. Yeah. Beside the lessons, you may give another. Maybe about you want to make your video, your experience video about your wonderful experience, and then you want to tell it to us. Yeah, using these clips, animated video clips. Yeah, and then this video, especially, yeah, apply for my workshop. That is to avoid uninteresting learning process. Yeah, the boring atmosphere of learning process that I found from my class. Okay, yeah, because as we know from the previous explanation, it is that learning grammar is something difficult, complicated. Many students give up. They don't want to join to learn for the class. Yeah, they prefer to speaking class, maybe listening class. Yeah, as we know that this has become the problem, not only for men, but for the other lecturers, okay? Yeah, for the other educational principals. Yeah, they have the problem with this, the way. Yeah, we have some method, the changes of the teaching grammar, how to avoid, the boredom of the class because of the teaching of the grammar. We have the communicative way, like this. We try to make it an interactive, dynamic way, how we deliver, how we convey a grammar, but we use that, we insert that in the animated video creation. Okay? Yeah.
Okay, makasih, ma'am.
Okay, ya welcome.
Nah, masih ada sisa satu pertanyaan lagi nih.
Thank you, ma'am.
Jadi yang mau nanya enggak? gimana nih, Mem? Masih mau terima pertanyaan atau kita udahin?
Boleh, masih bisa satu. One more question.
Oke, okay, satu pertanyaan lagi nih,
bisa
teman-teman.
Bisa nambah lagi ya, Mem, ya, pertanyaannya? Oke, okay, satu pertanyaan lagi. Ayo, ayo. Ternyata ini aplikasinya menarik sekali ya, Mem, ya. Dia juga bisa ganti dialek. Dialeknya, yeah. Accent-nya bisa
yeah,
diganti.
That's right. Yeah, that's
ada,
right, Anthony.
Ada Indonesia juga bisa, mm-hmm. Ada Indonesia juga, ada Spanyol.
That's right.
Dan
yeah,
sebagainya.
Yeah,
banyak
dialogue,
sekali aksennya.
Yeah? Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
In English, Mandarin, yeah? And other languages. You may create that.
Boleh nih langsung di-download ya. Apalagi buat tugas kuliah yang suruh buat animasi gitu kan. Cocok banget.
Nah, Mem. Ngomong-ngomong soal aksen nih, Mem. Kalau misalkan, saya kan orang Indo nih, Mem, ya. Orang Indo nih. Kalau saya ngomong bahasa Inggris kan tentu sulit saja ya, Mem, ya, untuk beraksen seperti native speaker di sana. Nah, apakah itu tidak apa-apa ya, Mem, ya? Kalau misalkan aksen saya itu kurang.
Oke. Okay. Well, we are not the native speaker of English, ya, yeah, Anthony? And the others? We are not the native speaker of this of English. So, yeah, many people speak in English. If you see the Chinese, they have the different accent. Yeah, Indian, when they speak English, they have different accent. I think the same like, what's that? In our language, Indonesian, yeah? Javanese, if they speak Indonesian, of course, they have their accent. They have their dialect. So we cannot really 100% like the native speaker. Yeah, Anthony? We cannot 100% similar, the correct pronunciation similar like the native speaker. Okay, because this is can be the second language or the foreign language. Every people have different accent in speaking the English. Yeah, that's the question. Yeah, that's the answer from ma'am.
Yang penting understandable ya, Mem, ya. Yang penting bisa,
yes,
dipahami gitu ya, Mem.
Yeah.
Kan ada juga tuh misalkan dialek yang dari Singapura atau dari Jepang gitu kan punya dia,
yes,
itu dialeknya sendiri ya, aksennya sendiri. Ya. Yeah. Oke.
Okay. Mana nih satu pertanyaan lagi? Mau nunggu atau gimana? Yuk teman-teman tanya dong. Masih ada Memnya nih.
Ayo dong, langsung tanya-tanya. Yang punya pertanyaan gitu langsung tanya aja. Nggak apa-apa kok. Nggak harus dalam bahasa Inggris juga.
Iya, pakai bahasa Indonesia juga nggak apa-apa.
Iya. Kalau mau pakai bahasa Inggris juga nggak apa-apa.
Tadi ayo. Kalau nggak salah itu Randy, itu ya, raise hand ya. Mau tanya atau
iya,
gimana?
Tadi ada yang raise hand.
Si Randy ya. Gimana nih, Mem? Masih mau nunggu atau enggak?
Oke. Okay. If no more question, okay. So I think that's enough. We can end this workshop.
Okay.
Yeah, Anthony, Johanna.
Okay, Mem.
Yeah, hopefully you get something the benefit from this workshop. Okay, student. Yeah, you may join at STEMIC Pontianak.
Oke, okay, boleh di close, Ana.
Oh ya, sebelum kita close, kita mau itu foto bersama dulu.
Oh,
yeah. Ya.
Foto bersama dulu. Open cam dulu dong.
Open cam dulu dong, teman-teman.
Kami mau lihat wajah kakak-kakak dan adik-adik abang-abang yang cantik-cantik dan ganteng-ganteng.
Kita foto bersama, terus kita boleh leave.
Barangkali mau mutualan juga ya, silahkan. Ayo, ayo.
Ya semua belum.
Masih belum nih, masih banyak yang belum nih.
Loh.
Ayo. Ayo, masih banyak nih yang belum nih. Di screen saya yang halaman pertama ada Lydia, Meita, kemudian ada Randy. Nah, masih banyak nih yang belum open nih.
Ini teman-teman dari sekolah mana ya?
Waduh. Ada keren-keren nih. Aduh, saya melihat ada Pak Tony. Halo Pak Tony. Oke. Okay. Ya, mungkin segini ya. Kita foto lah ya. Oke. Okay. 3, senyum dong, senyum. Peace, waduh. 3, 2, 1. Oke. Okay. Yuk, satu halaman lagi. Yuk, halaman belakang. Yuk. Yuk, 3, 2. Senyum dong. 3, 2, 1. Oke.
Udah, okay, Bang Antoni. Sudah.
Makasih, teman-teman.
Yeah. Yeah. Makasih, teman-teman, atas pastinya seminar kali ini. Boleh, teman-teman, boleh. Teman-teman, boleh. Ya. Yeah.
Ya, terima kasih teman-teman telah hadir dalam webinar kita kali ini. Minggu depan ada webinar lagi ya, sepertinya.
Iya. Makasih juga ya, Mem.
Stay tune, teman-teman.
Ya, welcome.
Ya, terima kasih, Mem, atas waktunya.
Iya.
Telah memberikan kami materi yang sangat bermanfaat ini ya, Mem, ya.
Ya, terima kasih. You're welcome.
Terima kasih, Dadah. Mem. Terima kasih, Kak.
Dadah.
Oh, ini handball. Dah, nanti aku dah akan nyam baru nyampaknya. Kuliah ini. Ini kuliah.
udah selesai.